Today, the topic of video lecture is curve fitting. This is our first lecture on curve fitting. For curve fitting, we must know what is its use. The use of curve fitting is to know the regression of variable and also to know the relation between the variable for the analysis of data. Regression analysis is used to model and analyze numerical data consisting of values of an independent variable x and a dependent variable y. So dependent variable y changes with respect to the independent change in independent variable. Curve fitting is a general method of finding equation between the given variables x and y, independent variable and dependent variable respectively, to approximate the curve on the basis of given data, and that is called a curve fitting. In other words, it is the representation of relation between two variables x and y in terms of algebraic expression. The purpose of finding a relationship is to know the relationship between the variables to confirm the relationship. There are various methods of finding the fitting of the curves. One of well-known method is a least square method. So let us first we discuss, there are different types of curve: straight line, then curvilinear, that is a parabola, then exponential curves. All right, exponential curves, straight line and a parabola. So let us see first the method of least square for the fitting of straight line. Okay, so for this, let us start with the equation of a straight line. Suppose the line to be fitted is y is equal to a plus bx, right? So this equation has how many constants? 1a and second b. So from these two equations, you will get two normal equations. So what is the method of finding normal equations? So coefficient of a is 1 and coefficient of b is x, right? So first multiply by the coefficient of a to whole equation 1 and then take summation. So if we multiply by 1, it will remain same, y is equal to a plus bx, and its summation will be equal to summation y is equal to summation a plus summation bx. Summation a is equal to n into a, and summation bx will be equal to b into summation x. So thus normal equations, first normal equation is given by this method, and that is equal to summation y is equal to n a plus b summation x. Is that clear? Then another normal equation, multiplying equation 1 by the coefficient of b, that is x. So it will become xy is equal to ax plus bx square. Now taking summation, so it will be summation of xy is equal to a summation x plus b summation x square. So this is another equation. Is that clear? then solving equation 2 and 3. Now let us see equation 2 and 3. Here the value of summation of y can be determined from the given values of y. Summation of x can be determined from the given values of x. Summation of x, y can be determined by calculation table. And summation of x square also can be determined from the table. Okay, so then substituting these values and solving equation 2 and 3, we will get the values of a and b. And after substituting these two values in equation 1, the equation of straight line which was assumed, we will get the best fit of straight line to the given data. Okay, required equation of straight line fitted to given data. So let us evaluate the first, we confirm this method by evaluating one example. All right, so let us see first example. Fit a straight line to the given data. X is equal to 1.53, 1.78, 2.60, 2.95, 3.45, 42. Y is equal to 33.50, 36.30, 40.00, 45.85, 53.40. Is that clear? Here it is not mentioned that key which is dependent and independent variable. So in that, by default, we always consider y as a dependent variable. So equation of straight line to be considered as y is equal to a plus bx. So let this straight line be y is equal to a plus bx. So as we have seen in the previous slide, there will be two normal equations as there are two constants a and b. The first normal equation is same for the coefficient of a is equal to 1, that is summation of y is equal to na plus b summation of x. And the second normal equation for the coefficient of b is equal to x is summation of xy is equal to a summation x plus b summation x square. Okay, and now various calculations. Okay, so we have here the table. Initially we prepare two columns, that is the column for the values of x, column for the values of y. These are the values of x. Now adding all these values, you will get summation of x. This is summation of x. Similarly, these are the values of y, and adding all these value of y, you will get summation of y, right? Then multiply x into y, x into y, x into y, x into y, x into y. So you will get this xy, right? And now adding all these values, so you will get summation of xy. Then doing the square of x, to x square 1.53 square is 2.3409. Similarly, 1.78 square is 3.1684. 2.6 square is 6.76. Likewise, all these squares. And now adding all these squares, you will get this summation of x square. All right. And now substituting these values of summation of x, summation of y, summation of xy, and summation of x square in equation 2 and 3. And here n is equal to what? The number of observations are 5. So n is equal to 5. So you will get 5a plus b summation x means 12.28b is equal to 209.05. And equation 3 will become as a summation x, that is 12.28a plus b summation x square, that is 32.668 is equal to summation x y, that is 537.755. Now solving these two equations by simultaneous equation method. So there are different methods of solving. So you can use the method of solving Cramer's rule. Solving this equation for and b. So first we find out the determinant of the coefficients of a and b. coefficients of error 5 and 12.28. Coefficients of B of 12.28 and 32.668. So their determinant is this. And value of the determinant is 5 into 32.6682 minus 12.28 into 12.28. So it becomes as 12.5426. Now we find out delta A. Delta A means in the determinant of delta, we remove these coefficients of A by these right hand side values. Right? So you will get this. And now this into this minus this into this is equal to this. That is delta A. Similarly, delta B is was replacing the coefficient of B by constant values. These are constant values. And now solving this, what you get? 5 into this minus this into this. So it is 121.641. That clear? Now substituting these values, A is equal to what? Delta A by delta. So this is the value of delta A, this is the value of delta. So it comes out A is 18. Alright. Similarly, B is equal to delta B by delta. So you will get delta B is this. Delta is 12.5426. So B comes out as 9.7. And finally, substituting the values of A and B in equation 1, the equation which was assumed for the fitting of the data. Okay, so it becomes as y equal to a plus bx and 18 plus 9.7x. Is that clear? So in this way, we can solve the more number of examples for fitting of the straight lines. Okay.